Hello, my fellow brothers and sisters in the Lord. I come to you today in the name of Yeshua Adonai. It's like a proverb in African language, Yoruba. They said, if a child can think, then the child can surely be able to praise and thank his the Maker. He said it like this: Tiomodeba, I thank God for giving me the privilege to do this. What I'm doing now, for God to come into the mission field. This message is just like for you all, my brother and sister in the Lord, who are children of God out there to know. This is the topic of this message. I just want to round up and bring it up is, who is like thee, O God, among the God of the whole universe? There is no God like the Almighty God, the Creator of heaven and earth. And we all, as a children of God, as a child of God, we need to make sure we hold on to that God. No matter whatever challenge that we may be faced or we may face on our way on journey on earth, life is a journey and life is a battle. Why I brought this song, this message is between a word and a mess and a song, just to appreciate the goodness of God. Last time I delivered a message about pastor in Freemason, which God gave me that message. After I deliver that message, it's like a war. That's why I need to bring this message out about, just to have shaped God, just for the children of God to know that this God we are serving is real and true and powerful God. But you just got to know who you are, and then all will be well. We face challenge day in and day and us. The moment we are still here on earth, God have a purpose for us and he have a calling upon our life. If I put myself on the scan and say scan my picture, the picture of my life from even when I was in my mother womb, for you to know that for me being alive is just for, they say, when they say you have a calling and you have a purpose and you cannot go, or you cannot, there's no matter whatever Satan and his agent may throw on your way, you got to fulfill that calling, and you got to fulfill the purpose and the calling that God have for you in this world. There is a time that even when God showed me this revelation, that I saw myself in a building and I saw Jesus Christ. The moment I entered that building, I was just crying. I said I wanted to go home. I wanted to go home. I wanted to go home. That's the word I was speaking. And when I think back now, I said, now I know the reason why God said to me that he spared my life for a purpose. I have some work that I need to do. There are some things that it's only you that can do it. And if you refuse, God will just chuck you away and use somebody else. And that's how it works. It was like God was telling me, you have not fulfilled your mission. You have not fulfilled your calling. I have a soul that you need to win into my kingdom. And it's only you that can do this. That's why I spare my life. Sometimes when I sit down, I said, now I know the reason why this God really do what he did in my life. Because he know that this work, I made you, I use you, I need you to do this work for me. After that, then you can go home. I will take you home by myself. He took Elijah home by himself. He was saying, I'm using you so that then when the time come, I will take you home by myself. Because inside the revelation that I saw myself, I was crying. I said, I want to go home. I want to go home. I want to go home. I was on my knees pleading, begging Jesus that I want to go home. But his dress is too wide, that his dress was the light of the building. The building where I saw him, that I was leaning on the floor and telling him I want to go, his dress was just too pure white that you can be able to If I lift my head up to see his face, the light in his face will just zoom your face and burn you up. I was looking at him from his feet, from his leg down. I can't lift my eyes to look at his head, the shape of his eyes, because it's like it was made with a light. The light that was in his eyes will just blow you up. I was looking at his dress. His dress was put the light inside the building. And inside the building, I saw a shed, and the shed was full of maggots. All the food store that was on that shed was full of maggots, cream color, big maggots. And I was just telling him, I said, I want to go home. I want to go home. He didn't say a word to me. He was just looking at me. I saw his shape. He was looking at me. And I saw a doorway that you can take to go. If you enter that doorway, you can pass. I saw the doorway. He just used his hand to stop the doorway so that I don't pass that doorway. Because I was saying to him that I wanted to go home. But his hand, he just blocked the doorway like this, that I can't go. Then he showed me a lot of big television screen. Why a lot gets my book? Some are coming on the way. I'm so busy now that I said, God, I need the wisdom from heaven to give me more strength. So that all this laziness tired, so that I can be able to, because what is in my hand is between, is something, when they say you have life support machine in your hand, but you are not using it. There are people who need that life support, like a tablet. You have the tablet in your hand and you are not giving it out. And you can see it's like even a sin. Sometimes when I'm tired, I say, well, you got to give me strength so that I can continue writing this thing, so that then it can quickly go out and deliver and be with your children. And so that I don't want to get to man. You said to me that I didn't complete my work. Sometimes if it's a sin, I say, God, forgive me. Sometimes when I'm writing, I say, oh, in case God take me home, at least my children can go and see where I complete and publish whatever. If I didn't finish the book, at least they can publish it halfway like that. Sometimes I think something like that in my heart. I say, God, but the work, I need to fulfill it. I need to complete it. What I was saying is that I said this word that, who is like you, oh God? Let me come back now. I delivered a message few weeks ago, few months ago. I don't know if it's a month now or a week ago, about Pastor Efremesi. God gave me that message in July. Before July, God already gave me part of that message, but I did not understand the full of it. Then in July this year, God gave me the full detail of it, and I share it out. But the full detail of it are in the book. What happened after I delivered that message? As I was giving you all out the message, sometimes I say, God, now I know the reason why the shore that you cover me with. In 2013, in this house, God came and visited me. And the prayer shore, Talib, that the Israelites used to cover themselves, that Talib came down on me. Then I saw a silver knife. God put it in my hand. I saw it in my hand. When God do that, I said, God was good. And a lot of things, he spoke to me, a lot of things. Even when I saw the Talib, I did not understand the meaning of the talib. I said, maybe did I need to go and buy talib? Maybe I went on the line to buy the talib, but the one they sent to me was the short one from Israel. I said, okay, next time I will plan, next time when I go to Israel, I will go and get the khaki one. I did not know the meaning of this. I said, God, what's the meaning? Or maybe you want me to be tying my head when I'm going out. I'll go and look for scarf now and be putting on scarf on when I'm going out. Even in winter time, I like to keep myself warm. I usually have different type of hat that I have. I said, God, maybe you want me to go and be putting on hat. I did not understand some of this meaning. It's later on, as God starts training me, I myself am in the spiritual school of my own school. Is not the school that you can sit down and teacher will teach you. My own school is from heaven. Is the spirit of the living God will start teaching me and be breaking out some of this message from us. They are giving me. They are giving me not to feed myself alone. They are giving me so that I too can be able to give out. And that's what I'm giving you all out. Anytime I bring the message out, or you can get some message in my book, and that's how I bring some of the word out. And the spirit of the living God led me a lot inside my book. About three of my book coming out was I just ask God to help me. God wants to all pastors is coming out. Do not give up. Episode this way is coming out. They do ask God first. That one too is coming out, but it's just a matter of time for those books to be together. Do not did you ask God first? It's about young people. You may be old. The class is not age. You may be old, but you can still get that book. It's about marriage and a lot of. You are not alone. No other help but God alone. You see, I'm just asking God for the strength of those books. But as they come out, try to get one. Why I'm breaking, I'm coming back here just to round up a word for you all. God, there's no power you can compare to the power of God. If you know God, you will benefit yourself, and not only for yourself alone, but for your generation coming up. When God gave me the message about pastor in Freemason, and God gave me another revelation after that, that I quickly get up on that day to come and upload it. As I was uploading it, I'm coming back now, I was feeling shivering. When I say shivering, I did not know that's not the end of it. I delivered the message, and by the time I'm doing it, part two, the Yoruba language one, African language one, I felt more cold as I said, oh, what? This is like, it's like, even if you just arrive in England, you can't feel that kind of cold that I felt on that day. That's when, at night, as I went to go to bed, that night or night after, it's like, you know, zoo, if you've been to a zoo, it's like all the animal in the zoo just come and run to me in my bed, that I was using my hand like this. I was using my hand like this. It's like they open the animal in the zoo, and all kind of animal you can measure them on this earth, they are just blowing to me, like fighting me, that I was doing like this. I said, God, by the time I woke up, I was shaking. I said, God, wow, who is like you? Oh God, among the God of the whole universe. Now I know the reason. I now know the meaning of the show that came down on me. It's like this kind of thing, you can't do it alone. You need a protection from heaven. And it's like God was saying, I've already protected you. I've already covered you with my armor. I know animal on earth and woman being. The messenger for the children of God. And you can see, I took the message out. Then God said, I put his message in the bin. And that's when I went to deliver the message back. And when I delivered the message out, it's like they open all the lion, all the animal in the zoo, just come on me and fight me. That I was, after a couple of days, I was a little bit not feeling better. But thank God, the strength of God lift me up. I'm okay. Now I remember a word God said to me, that some of us are not human beings, some of us are animal. Then my brain just go back to that message when God said some of us are animal. I said, okay. I grabbed the word. God, there's a time a guy sent me a message and said to me that, oh, all you these people, they should just shut you up and they should just close you up with all your dream and revelation. Who are you? All kind of bad comments. And I said, God, but you asked me to deliver the message. Look at what this man was saying. And then God showed me a revelation. And I just saw this man. He was eating sand. Ah, I said, God, By the time I nearly wanted to ask God for mercy over his life, that's when God gave me that word that not all of you are human beings. Some of you are animal. And by that night after God showed me, when God showed me the revelation, when I saw a lot of things, animal now coming, after I deliver that message about free mercy, I said, God, it is true. Some of us are not human beings. There is a lot of animal out there. If you are a pastor or God called you into the ministry, make sure God empower you with his power. Do not go out and start your ministry without the power of God, without the anointing of God. Get my book. What did I say? Get my book. Before 2006, I think around 2004, I went into the mission field without God anointing, without God saying go and start and establish a ministry. I bought acres of land in Nigeria, West Africa. I wanted to do it to have a retreat center where people can go and pray to God one to one. I'm telling you, between when I started that thing, I bought the land at Otta, Nigeria, West Africa. It's even later on I was told that Pastor Joe have a farm near there and Winner Chapel Church. What I see in that time, what I see even now, by that time I was in the marriage made from hell. But as I was in that marriage, my soul, my spirit, see, I'm still hungry for the word of God. I'm still hungry to do the will of God, but I was tied down. If you wanted to go into the ministry, if you are a pastor or you are God called you into the ministry, your pastor can anoint you. They can send you to mission field. Oh God, please get my book. Everything is there. I said, your pastor can anoint you. Your pastor can send you to the mission field to go and work. But there's something that your pastor can never give you, and it's the power from above. If you have that power, you can face lion. If you have that power, you can face tiger. If you have that power, your even family will be scared of you. They may be thinking maybe you are witch, but it's not you, because they can see their higher power, that there is a power that is above, that is guiding you. Because they will realize that all what they are doing to harm you or to do you evil is coming back on them. And they may be thinking you are the one that is doing it, which they did not know that there is higher power. There is a power that is above all power, which is the power of God, who is like the whole God, among the God of the whole universe. If you have this power, it is well. It is well. You can go to the mission field and you can. I start the mission field earlier. Around 2000, I start the mission field. And I'm telling you, not until 2013, when God gave me the weapon. A knife was put in my hand, and then prayer showed from heaven. Before 2013, before God visited me, and before I even started the mission field, I know I was called into the mission field, but I did not know what direction to start with. I know there's something going on. There's something that God wanted to use me for. Because there's a time, even as I was in the wrong marriage, I saw a man came and I was kneeling down, and it just like how Samuel anointed David. Anointing oil was falling on me in that dream as I was kneeling down. Anointing oil was falling on me that. In that dream, I said to the man that as I was anointing, I said, what about my children? I was thinking maybe because as they anoint, the anointing, as they anoint me, my children too, they should anoint them. And all this, I did not know the reason of it. This one was before even year 2000, around 1998. Or 1997, around 1998 or 1999, I did not click in what's going on. It was later. Dream and revelation, they are not something new to me now. They are new to me over 20 years ago, because when I have God showing me a dream and revelation, I think they are just ordinary dreams. I don't even have a pastor that I can say I'm having some dream or revelation, they should explain it to me. No, I just think they are just ordinary things. But when you are in the cage, no way. When Joseph was tied down in the pit, there's no way from the pit you can do what you feel like you wanted to do, until when you come out of that pit, then you can be able to be free. Who is like you, O God? That's why I brought this message out and said, who is like you, O God? No matter whatever challenge we may be facing through, no matter whatever it is, we should know that there is higher power above. And if you have that higher power, all is well. It's not like the power you all get nowadays, that you involve yourself with occultists and you are using all this power of darkness, doing miracle, having church branch all over the whole world. It's not that kind of power. All those power, they have their expiring date. Read my, there's a message there, get my book. All those power, they have expiring date. You can be the president today with that power. You can have your church everywhere on earth with that, with the power of Satan. But the day God is going to destroy you, he will deal with you. And after you die, all those churches will be closing down. That's the secret of it. Get my book. Who is like you, O God, among the God of the whole universe? And you children of God, my brother and sister in the Lord, I love you all. That's why I brought this message out for you, that there's no one like our God. Hold on to that God who is like you. You need to have the experience of God before you can be able to say who is like him. I've had this experience. I told you, I delivered a message about Pastor in Freemasonry. And that night, it's like if they open a zoo, all the animals just rushed to me, that I was like this fighting. I was like this fighting. Fighting animal, not human being, or if they come in dragon or anything, I will say they come in dragon. Just name it, all the animal in the zoo. Vamp on me. That after a couple of days, I said, God, this work, I thank God for the power. I thank God you are true and living God. There's no God like you. I deliver the message. I, as God led me, all my messages are now in the book, but this one I just want to praise and say, thank God. There's no one like our God. Moses said the same thing in Exodus chapter 15, verses 11. Who is like unto thee, O God, among the gods? Moses knows there is a comma, there is a bracket of God on earth. Who is like thee, O God, among the gods? Who is like thee, glorious in holiness? Glorious means is powerful, is work. Do he wonder, you can see. Fearful, wonderful, praise, because it's work. You cannot compare how it work. Sometimes you may be praying and then God haven't answered to your prayer. You can fast 100 days, you can knock your head on the floor, but if the time that he put in hand to do a thing, if the time hasn't come, there's nothing you can do. I'm just trying to look. I think it's inside one of my book coming. No other help but God alone. For you to know that if you are going through any battle or any challenge in this world, hold on to that God. Hold on to him. He have a date and he have the time that he already put everything in time to do his work. Who is like thee? Remember the time of the children of Israel. Look at how many years they are enslaved. Look at what Pharaoh did to them. Still yet, they still hold on to God. Until when one day God raised Moses up and said, go and deliver my children. Go and tell the Pharaoh to let my children go. At the time, God already put everything in time. Sometimes when I look at it, I say, this God see what they are going through. God see everything, but there's no one like him. He bring me back to this message. I think that was in 2000 when I started going out on the in the tube station. By then I used to live in London. I would go around the train station. I'd be giving out leaflets. Sometimes I would take all my children. I'll be dividing them. You work for me this week. We go out on the street and do the leaflet this week. I will take another one another month. I will just be we go out and be giving out leaflets. And then once Saturday morning, we do it at the weekend. And during the week, I will go around. They say, "Card, haven't got it here. You may be watching it. Maybe if you are you used to live in East London." And there is a card. They usually call. They wrote in that card, "Jesus love you." At weekend or some weeks, I will go around houses. I'll be putting that leaflet inside that anybody inside the inside people's letterbox. I'll be putting it just for them to know that Jesus loved them and they are not alone. I did not know God was, when they said the steps of the good man are ordered by the Lord, that's when I start my ministry, going out and be giving out leaflet. What I wanted to bring this this message is about a woman. She said, "Get my book." Okay, let me just, as the Spirit of God led me to this woman message, everything, I wrote it in the book. One Sunday, Saturday afternoon, Saturday morning, because I usually go in the morning to do the, when people will be going out, going to shop, or that's where I go out and give the leaflet. The woman, I met a Jewish old woman, not young. She may be maybe in her 60 or 70 if I get her age right. I was giving her the leaflet. I said, "Jesus love you." She said a word to me that it's later in the years that God now, and now when I was walking through some challenge in life or something, then I remember the word the woman said. Then God was breaking the word to me. The reason, even take me time for me to remember, to know what she was talking about. The message the woman said, "I said, Jesus love you." She turned and looked at me and said, "She disappoint us." She turned and looked at me as I gave her the leaflet, because I stand at the entrance to the train station. As you are going through the train to take your train, I will stand there and just be giving out the leaflet. I'll make a lament of it. Very pretty, beautiful white card. I did it. I lament it with the paper machine, everything. Nice and beautiful that I know if they tear it, they won't be able to tear it. Then they will surely hold it because of the plastic on it. They can't tear it. That they may be going through some battle in their life, and when they think and see the card that Jesus loves you, they will think about it and some word I put on it, so that they don't know, so that they don't just think that they are abandoned in this set, so that they don't lose hope in the creator of heaven and earth. As this was, I think it was 2001 or no, 2007. I went out, I was giving that leaflet. That was when this woman said this word to me. She said to me, "Jesus disappointed them." She said, "He disappointed us." As she was going, I still got a few leaflets with me in my hand that I still wanted to give her. I could have said maybe to run with her to find out what happened. But as she was saying to me that Jesus disappointed them, okay, I said, "He still love you." Not until later on, God said, now said to me the meaning of the word the woman said. God now bring the message to me. You remember about the Jewish people, what they go through with Hitler in Germany. That's what God said. That's the reason the woman said it to me, that Jesus disappointed. Later on, as I was going, as I was thinking, I said, at the end, he still called for their rescue. It's many years past now, 87 or 88 now. Now when God bring the message to me, I will say, but at the end, he still come to their rescue. He still come to their rescue. Who is like thee, O God, among the God of the whole universe. Exodus 15, verse 11. Moses sang that song. But nowadays, we all just toy Christianity, they will just be singing that song like a rock and roll, without them knowing the meaning, the deep of that song. Who is like thee, O God, among the God of the whole universe? Moses see the power of God, and that's why he can be able to say that. And that song as well, I too can be able to say it. I even sing that song many years past. There's a time God showed me a revelation, and in that revelation, I saw myself flying, and I was saying, like when someone was flying, I was saying, who is like you, O God, among the God? It's later on, I find it in the Bible, in Exodus, that it was Moses that sang that song. Even by that time I sing the song, that song that I have in my revelation, I did not know God was calling me to the mission field. I did not, I will have a dream and revelation and think of, maybe they are just ordinary things. And Yoruba will say, oh, Defi, I get me to get me. It's not a joke. It really deal with me. All those dream and revelation that I know, I really see hell on earth with it. But today, I give God the glory. Who is like you, O God, among the God of the whole universe? Children of God, know God by yourself and know the God that you worship. Don't say, I worship the God of my father, or God of my mother, or God of my pastor. Worship the creator of heaven and earth, God of Abraham, God of Isaac, God of Israel, the true and living God. There's a song, I did this, I think, I did it yesterday. That song has come to me. Some song, as God is giving me vision, dream, and revelation, he put a song, some song, they gave me some song as well. I sat down, then I start the song, their message as well, that I will sit down and start reading it and start saying the meaning of it. There's a message God gave me about this song. God gave me a song, every time that song I will be repeating, coming out to my mind. And that song, I gave it a few days ago, yesterday. The song, for you to know, is in Yoruba song, but you all just got to know God by yourself. It's only in this world, it's only by God's grace and by God's purpose that each one of us can be able to fulfill our calling and our destiny. And if God has a calling upon your life as a child of God, you need to be very careful. Don't be going run and be asking people just to lay hand on you. There's another this thing message. Come, let me include this thing before I switch off. There's a message God showed me recently. Somebody sent me an email and said, please, sister, pray for me. And by the time I wanted to pray, I was praying. The person doesn't even need to know if I pray for her or not. In this earth, there are some people that God put aside. What they do, they pray for people in secret. I don't need to tell you if I pray for you. That's the secret. You all just thinking pastor work, some pastor at church. No, there are a lot of pastors that you don't need to know them. What they do, their own job is just to pray. They are on earth to guide the head, to guide the situation of what's going on in earth. Their prayer are a guide. Recently, incident happened in France. That Friday, I said, God, I was even blaming myself. I said, did I fast? Did I go on fasting or that day? Or that day, I didn't know something. I was just saying to myself, God, help me. I know by the time I woke up, I said, but I see the prayer, oh God. There are people like that all over the earth that God has signed. We don't need to tell you. I don't need to tell you the deep part of the deep of it. Every one of the children of God have a calling, that some people God put you in a calling. Make sure those are your side. You pray for everybody in that side. You make sure everybody is okay. And those side, if anything happens, Those who God put into that line, they will be blaming themselves and say, I'm sure I prayed. And if something bad happened, they will say, maybe God know the reason for it. And we just leave everything in God's hand. This message I'm bringing out now. Somebody sent me a message and said, sister, pray for me. By the time I'm coming with this message, I'm breaking it. I divide a lot of message I'm packing for you here now. By the time this person sent me the message to pray for her, by the time I said, Father God, I bring that person into your hand, and so. God just showed me a revelation where I was telling you that you need to be very, very careful in this earth. God just showed me a revelation that I saw a coffin, and inside the coffin, I saw a lot of knives. A lot of knives are inside that coffin. By the time I saw this, I said, God, what's going on? Then God sent my brain back to the message, to the dream that I have. Maybe you may be going around and be asking people to pray for you. Be careful. And be going to all this mega church, all this big pastor you met out there. Just be careful. This is the answer God gave me. Because by the time the person asked me, sister, remember me, pray for me. By the time I wanted to pray for that person, I was praying and said, God, please, you know, so, please help, help. When God showed me the revelation that I saw a coffin, and inside the coffin was filled with knife, then God took my mind back to the dream that he showed me many years past, that I saw myself. We are walking inside the Stadium Arena. Inside, you know how this big mega church is? As we are walking in, I saw a tin, silver bean tin on the floor. And then a man, a black, tall, skinny man, he was saying to us that before we go and sit down inside the arena, inside the church, the arena is like a church because I peeped through to see what's going on inside there. To see, inside there was very dark, but I know people are inside there. I peeped through to see. Then I saw people there. But inside the silver thing that they asked us to, as you are going inside the arena to sit down, they said to you that you first got to put your knife down. If you put your knife down, then you will go and sit down inside the arena. As the man said that, I looked inside the tin, inside the bin, I saw different kind of knife, shiny new one inside the bin. By the time I look at this, I said, I'm not going to put my knife down. I didn't say a word for the man to hear. I just said it. I shake my head. I said, I'm not going to put my knife down there. And I look up there. They have a camera there. They are using to monitor us. I said, okay, I know what to do. I will go and look for a place to hide myself, so that I'm not going to put my knife down. In that revelation, that's what I said. Then now, God take me back to the person I wanted to pray for. God said, it's like God was telling me that that person, maybe they've been going around everywhere. Those are the people, like when you go to some church, you think they are holy place, and they already collect all their glory. It's like the person now is empty because all what they need to use, all their glory, all their star, all their weapon they need to use on this earth has been collecting by a skinny, tall black man. He collects all the knife that people need to use because we was told to put our knife down inside the bin before we can go and see them. And if you are somebody like that, you need to be very, very careful. Stop going around and be asking people to be praying for you. Not even to be praying for you alone, but stop going around and be all this big, big mega church out there. Just be careful. Because as we human beings, as we are going there, the way we go in is not the way we are going to come out. If God reveals the deep of it for you, you will go and put a stand post and stand in front of all the mega church you know on earth and be telling people not to enter into it. Get my book. get my book. I can't say much here. All the details, everything are in it. As a child of God, be careful. No matter what challenge you may be going through, know that there is a powerful God who is like thee, oh God. Now let me bring you back to the message of the song that I put down a few days ago. The message is, it's in Africa Yoruba, but I just have got to help me with the English of it. Is I will sing it like this for you all who are Yoruba, who understand Yoruba. Is Oma Seni to feka goke afeni ti ori koyo longun o seni omo lewe e ma gbagbe o pe ko ma seni to feka goke afeni ti ori ba koyo ni won gun ni won gun ba lele e ma gbagbe o pe e ma seni to feka goke afeni ti oluwa ba koyo ni won gun ni won gun iya lele e ma gbagbe o pe e ma seni to feka goke afeni ti oluwa ba koyo ni won gun ni won gun omi dan mi e ma gbagbe o pe e ma seni to fe ka goke afeni ti oluwa ba kojo ni won gun ni won gun eyi omo mi e ma gbagbe o pe e ma seni to fe ka goke afeni ti oluwa ba koyo ni won gun ni won gun. It is well. Let me share with you. Hold on, hold on, hold on to the word of God, and all will be well in Jesus' name. You see, Obatoda Bire. Olorun nikan, the solid God, the only God. We face challenge day and night, but it is well. Stay blessed. Bye. Who is like thee, oh God? Bless no one. Bye.